thank you guys for Lori and Lisa. Thank you guys for asking me to judge. Always love coming up here. I've been up here for a while, and I always enjoy coming up here. So thanks for having me come up. But, so this is the land portion. So we're going to have an honor here too. So what we're going to do is have you come out of the holding blind. Go to the working bucket there. What we are judging, the things we're kind of looking for in the whole test is, you know, them listening to you, obedience, of course. You know, we want you to heal to the bucket. We don't want them there first, vice versa. So try to get your dog to get there with you and not in front of you. Once you get there, you're going to have the honor dog. So just check with them once you get ready. Make sure, you know, everybody's good. You're going to load 3 shells. The honor's going to load 1. You're going to start the test with the duck call. We're going to have bird 1 over here, right to left. Going to land towards that orange ribbon. Bird 2 is going to be the middle one. That's going right to left.
Out by the orange ribbon.
Out by the orange ribbon. Bird 3, right here, right to left. Once that bird hits the ground, you can release your dog, pick them up however you want. Okay. After the dog goes past these tracks, this trail right here, we're not going to be telling honor dog to leave. You are permission to leave. We don't want to mess up a dog leaving the line. So you've established, you sat there. You go ahead and get up after the dog's left. We want you to heel out to, you know, at least 2 or 3 steps. Put your leash on. Get out of there. Okay. Once you pick up your 3 birds, then we're on the way back from that 3rd bird, we're gonna radio out. Then the blind is over here where the yellow, where the orange ribbon is. We're gonna have him load that, so it's not gonna be a hot blind during the test. It will be planted, of course, when your 3rd bird's coming back. Come back after your 3 birds. On the way back from your 3rd bird, we're gonna throw a diversion. We will try to throw it away from your dog. So it's either going to be this side, I'm not going to throw it in your dog's face. Okay, that's kind of the diversion we're going to throw that. If we miss it, we'll get it back on the way back from the blind. Run the blind. We want dogs in front of the seat. So everybody's kind of running from the same spot. Whether you're right-handed, left-handed, you know, dog, to put the dog in front of the chair. You have as much room as you want, left to right. You know, there shouldn't be not anything. Looks like we're gonna have to watch the sun. I wasn't here yesterday. Hopefully that sun won't be a factor. For much, but there's just none of that sun back there, so I don't care if you need them. Get those birds, come back over here. You can receive your dog over here or over there, then walk over here and get ready for the next dog coming in. So what we want to see is, first of all, we want to see an obedient dog that has a good attitude coming down here, you know, nice and perky, ears up, it's wanting to go get these birds. Those are things that look good. We want a dog to sit there attentively, look at these marks, marks these birds. We don't want them to sit there quietly. When you're going on a mark, we expect them to go directly to the area, establish a hunt, and pick that bird up and come back. There is handling in the area of the fall that you can handle a dog kind of without getting penalized. Okay? So everybody kind of knows at this level, handling is usually a deduction. That's when, if you decide to handle on a mark, that means that marking and memory part is no longer there. We are judging you on them handling, and that means they got to go directly to the bird from where you stopped them. Now, if you're in the area of the fall, then that is still a good spot to handle, being safe for you. I tell people the average is a yard per 10 yards.
But these people don't know, and a lot of people don't.
Okay.
I'll mention that.
So you put a diameter around a yard per 10 yards. That is what the majority of judges know. This is just an average of what we consider the area of fall. That's not the hunt area. The hunt area is bigger than that, right? But the area of the fall to handle in and be safe, objectively, is a yard per 10 yards. So that kind of gives you an idea of what we're thinking about. Wind changes that. Wind blowing this way, the bird's here, that area of the fall moves that way.
The hunt area.
The area of the fall and hunt area. Both move based on that. Okay. We'll let you know if you handle and you're in the area of the fall.
If you don't know, ask. We'll tell you.
We'll let you know. Yes.
I've never ran out of this field, but that's a memory bird over there. If that dog gets in that trees, should we be worried about these cars?
The wind's blowing this way. Obviously, the bird's laying right there. That's a pretty good distance.
Probably looked better from over here.
Obviously in the trees they didn't mark the bird very effectively. And if you handle them, we'll judge based on where we think you're at. Me personally, if my dog I thought was going there, I'd stop my dog, put it right on there real quick.
Absolutely. So if we have issues, we'll have to move it.
I'm not going to let your dog have anything. I mean, we'll see how it goes. We're not here to hurt any dog. Dean, you have anything to say about that? Or?
This is behind where that bird drops to. So.
But usually that's a brick wall.
You know.
Those things are. You know, the dog didn't see anything in the woods. Questions about what we're judging or how we're looking at dogs. John's going to go over gun safety, then we'll get started.
Housekeeping first, cell phones off if you're going to have them on you. I don't want to hear a duck call going off. Sometimes running my dog, my cell phone off, or even the ring. Housekeeping also, these grounds are pretty nice. I haven't seen any tracks running around, so please don't throw any. If you do pick it up. 870 is our standard HRC gun. The only club. If you pay insurance for that, if we abuse this, we can lose this. When we're shooting your mark, we want you to aim, shoulder the gun, aim, track, and shoot at the top of the arc or somewhere thereabouts. If you follow the mark down, which I have no problem with, pull it back up before you move to the next mark. I don't want you to flip the dog with the gun at a gun safe. And when you load the gun, I can't stand there. And my dog's sitting here and there's a gun barrel right there. Mm-hmm. If I see that, you will get a gun warning. I want that gun up in the air. This is gun safe. There has been, and I know a guy who had a semi-automatic shotgun. He loaded it. The dog was sitting there. He was loaded. He closed the chamber. The button, he couldn't close it. The gun closed, and then off the door of the dog. Gun barrel up in the safe direction at all times. You guys have been doing this long enough, y'all know that, right?
So aim, track, and shoot top of the arc. Follow the bird down, that's fine, and no problem. Take it back up before you swing to the next mark. Safe gun, chamber open, safety on. It's a safe gun. That's how you pick it up out of the rack, both two, and that's how you put it down in the rack. Chamber closed with the safety on. Is the gun warning? Chamber open and safety off is also a gun. Safety off, chamber closed is a gun violation or an elimination, and you are done for the day. You and that dog. And you cannot run any more dogs in any other state in the test. Bad day. You have to get somebody else to run the dogs. Guess anything? Good?
Yeah, just, I don't know. The honor is shooting the last bird.
Yes, last bird.
Last bird out. Okay.
The last bird.
The last bird. This
boat
bird.
Call. Start the test.
But that bird. Yes. Shooting that way. Shooting that way. Okay. We'll try to help remind you.
Do we have the option to shoot the bird standing, or do you want us on the seat?
I'd rather you.
Doesn't matter to me.
You can do which one. The dog has to sit on honor. You can't lay down, anything like that. So the dog's got to sit on your honor. Okay, just to mark the birds. Questions? Yes.
When we first move our dog honor, though, we can lay our dog down until the working dog is there.
Correct? Yes.
Okay. I just wanted to be sure. Yes.
Well, they just have to be sitting during...
During the test, yep.
During the birds being...
Blind.
I'll be right over here. Nice set of marks. And get the bob. There goes one.
Here. Come on. Heel. Sit. Arch. Open and save.
Thank you.
Heel. Sit. Now we're doing a blind.
Yes, sir.
Blind planner?
Yes,
ready?
Ready.
Third one.
We went in the bucket.
They're in the bucket. All the ducks are in the bucket, Lori. They've been in there all morning.
Ginger!
She's
been there.
I know.
Yeah, it's a
nice mark.
Been there
or not.
Plant the blind, John.
Yeah.
Plant the blind.
What?
Sorry, said they're looking for a gentleman helping out over here with the last important.
Yeah.
He's in the blind out there.
There goes one.
Lord. Thank you.
Atta dog, good.
Plant the blind, oh, plant the blind.
There goes one. Let you know there's a you know several that had some blind issues that you know we need some tighter blinds. We'll let you know if you are one of those, just to kind of give you an update on what we would like to see. So really, other than that, we'll kind of let you know if you've handled this morning. Just to remind you, it's kind of helpful. So what we're going to do, you're going to walk down. We'll just come off out of lead right here. Come on down.
Got you. Come on down.
So just come off lead, come down to the chair. At the heel, we'd like to see finished control. You can remind your dogs as you're going down there. We don't want heel, but yeah, you can remind your dogs. But we do want them healing. When you get to the chair, get ready. You're going to load one. We're going to have first bird. Whenever you're ready, call. Bird, come out, shoot. Then you're going to turn. Load two, call, you have bird one, come out, kind of angle in to the left.
In front of the big bird.
And then bird two here.
Bird three.
Bird two over here. Going to be right there, which will be bird three. Get them in any order. Pick up your birds. We're going to load the blind appropriately. So when you guys are done over here, we might be having someone load that blind. So it might be hot while you're running this bird. You see what I'm saying? It's not going to be hot while you're running either of these birds. Is that fair? I mean, that's kind of what we're going to do.
Yeah.
Everybody sees the orange there. Okay.
So the bird is going to be down close to the water as we can get it.
So just kind of with this room, dog can be over here. We don't, I don't mind if you move this chair back to give you a little bit more room. You can, you got all the space you want. Okay. Just don't go forward or backwards because we will have fun laughing, but then I'll save you. I guess. And that's it. We've already done our other stuff. Yeah, so that's all we got to do. Okay. Gun safety. Everybody did pretty good this morning. The only thing we noticed, and I just told everybody, you know, John Wayne is not here. He is gone. We need the gun up here. And a diversion is always what gets people because it's quick. Gets me too. But it's just a reminder for further things. That's all I tell people, you know, just to remind you. So keep the breech open, safety on. That's a good gun. Let us know. That's always awesome to let us know. Of course, breech closed, safety off. Together is you're gone. No one's going to do that. We're going to tell you before you do that, okay? If the breech is, if it's put down with the safety off and breech open, that is a violation. Or the breech closed, safety on is a violation. So we want to see it. Safety on and breech open, always point it up. Load your shells up. Shoot at the top of the arc. Everybody, like I said, did pretty good at that. Questions? John, anything else?
Right.